I want to feel it. I want to feel it. I want to feel it. Feel it. Feel it.
Freedom. Freedom, breaking away from slavery.
And then the Lord will scatter you among all nations, from one end of the earth to another. Deuteronomy 28, verse 64. If you were to ask some scholars about the verse, they might reference the African diaspora. Whether any of that is true, it has piqued my interest. A scattered population whose origin hailed from Africa, I want to learn more. And among many places in the world you can find the diaspora, Palenque, Colombia is very interesting. Built by runaway slaves in the 17th century, Palenque, Colombia became the first documented free slave towns in the America. Because of that very reason, I've decided to visit the town to learn more about its culture and its connection to Africa. What's up, guys? I'm here in Palenque. I'm visiting the town because a lot of you guys have requested to. If you're wondering where Palenque is, it's like south of Cartagena in the Maria Mountains and the Department of Boulevard, right?
Yes.
That's Joely. She's been in a couple of my videos. Her family's from here. She's born in Barranquilla, but her family's from this part of town. And we're at her auntie's house. Let's go look at your auntie's house. Come on.
My main thing here, guys, is I want to show you more than the tourist life, the everyday life. Okay, here we go.
We've seen a lot of tourist videos, but I want to see how normal life is here, and we're at her family's house. This is a beautiful home, by the way. You know? What's going on, family? What's going on?
Buenos dias. ¿Qué más? ¿Cómo está usted? Para mí es un placer saludarlo.
He said, hello, buenos dias. You guys know what that means, and he's happy to see you, alright?
Soy cartagenero de descendencia palenquera. Mis padres son palenqueros. Ellos son mis padres.
Ah, okay. So he was born in Cartagena, but this is his family right here.
Ellos son mis padres.
And this is his parents, actually, and they were born here.
Alright, guys. So I'm putting my mask on, because I know that's going to be the topic of discussion. But, we're gonna go check out the city right now. Let's do it.
So we got Ronald here. He speaks a little English. What's yes. going on? Where you learn English from?
I was a Martin Luther King student. It's a program for young black men here in Colombia. Yeah, I get a scholarship.
Were you born here?
Yes.
So I was asking him, like, is there gonna be fiesta hoy?
Yes, hoy is, you know, hoy is
let's go. Vamos a fiesta.
Vamos, esta es la calle principal.
Okay, this is the main street right here.
In Palenque. Mm-hmm. Here you can see the cemetery. Y cuando entre, sea lo primero que le diga. Saludes a nuestro ancestro.
Ah, por eso está aquí enfrente.
Eso tiene so una
they, okay, so they actually put the cemetery here in front. So once you come in, salute the passing.
¿Cómo estás?
Bien. Ah, you speak English. What is gardita?
Agaretia.
What is that?
Cuando tú te emocionas, estás bebiendo.
Okay, you get it crunk. Basically, that's what it means. Agaretia.
Uh-huh.
¿Cómo se dice?
Agaretia.
Agaretia. Hay un otro lengua aquí. ¿Tú hablas esa lengua?
Susto, sabes, la chita animó. Chiste asunto aquí en Palenque. Agüe y asindí jarocho porque no a mí ni.
No sabía que estaba hablando, pero it looks a little Brazilian, though. Hold on. The streets are noticing a common trend. There's no face mask. This town is basically doing their own thing. From what I understand, they don't even have a police department here. Guys, check out this artwork right here. This is basically the story of Palenque in some artwork, okay? So you see the guy with the hand in the chain that was a slave. Okay, he was from Africa. Then he ended up in South America. And he still has the same culture pretty much. You want to talk about the diaspora? That's something that's a common trend within the African community. That drum, that beat. We all feel it in our soul. It's like in our DNA, that type of music.
Enseñan tienen que ser palenquero.
Oh, okay, wait a minute. So guys, he was just telling me this is basically the elementary school. If you want to teach here, you have to speak Palenque. What makes lengua palenque?
Es una lengua con toda la complejidad gramatical que existe. Es una lengua que tiene tres elementos fundamentales. Bantu africano, portugués y español.
¿Y por qué portugués? He said Bantu, Portuguese, and Spanish is what really molded that language. I'm asking him,
Why Portuguese?
Portugués porque es una sencilla razón. Acuérdate que nuestros ancestros fueron transportados desde distintas partes de África en barcos negreros. Lo que se llaman barcos negreros o barcos donde transportaban a los esclavizados. Y la potencia para el transporte de los esclavizados eran los portugueses. Y como nuestros ancestros fueron capturados de distintos lugares de África, muchos no se entendían el lenguaje. Entonces tuvieron la necesidad de aprender otro lenguaje y fueron aprendiendo cosas del portugués porque quienes transportaban eran portugueses.
Si pasen a Brasil, no hay problema. ¿Tú conoces el lenguaje de portugués?
No exactamente la lengua, no sé, sino elementos de la lengua del portugués, así como elementos de lengua del bantú y del castellano. Porque la lengua palenquera...
Bantú,
Swahili y Kikongo.
Ok, la gente aquí de Congo, varios,
o sea, no podemos decir que toda nuestra gente de Congo, o sea, porque sería...
Hubo un grupo de descendientes que...
De distintas partes, hay muchísima gente que proviene de Congo, Angola, Guinea-Bissau específicamente, un poquito de Mozambique, muy poco ya de Nigeria, algunos. O sea, porque fue distinto, no podemos homenizar o decir que de un solo lugar.
So, he's basically saying that they can't define the group of Africans that came here to one country in Africa, but he's basically saying that there's a strong influence of the Congo influence here. And then what he also said something about Portuguese and I guess the transports that brought them here, they spoke Portuguese. For those who want to help me in the comments, clarify what he said, go by all means. This is interesting though. You got a lot of brothers out here, man. They look like some of my homies from the hood. Hey, you famous. Todo el mundo conoce a ti.
Sí, aquí en la comunidad todo el mundo se conoce.
Yeah, oh, okay.
He said, yo puedo conocer el palenquero aunque esté en Barranquilla, pero yo sé que es palenquero.
Oh, okay, so he can point out a person from Barranquilla, from Palenque. He pretty much knows everybody in the town.
Todo el mundo se conoce aquí.
Okay.
No hay palenquero que no conozca.
Okay. ¿Yo? ¿Palenquero?
Todos los palenqueros.
¿Yo parece palenquero? ¿Si no hablas? ¿Sí, muy gordo?
Si no habla.
If I don't talk, he's gonna. I'm actually. I look like
Palenqueño. Como de nosotros, sí. O sea,
he said I got some features. I could say I'm from Palenque. Okay. All right, bro.
Que tenemos el color.
The main thing is the color. But I think he knows based off the person's swag. Mi familia de Haití. Conozco Haití.
Claro, o sea. No he ido, pero yo conozco la historia de Haití. Fue el primer país libre.
¿País?
Sí, claro, libre. Pero antes que Haití...
¿Palenque?
Haití fue en 1804.
Sí, yo conozco.
Y Palenque fue en 1713.
Sí, ellos hacen lo primero de nosotros. Sí.
Pero yo conozco un poquito la historia del general Petión.
Bueno, yo quiero hablar contigo en mi gente lengua. Sacpase.
Sacpase.
Para dice, ¿qué pasando?
Sacpase. En mi lengua, ¿cómo cusata?
¿Cómo cusata? Okay, brother, that's what. Okay, you see that? Okay.
Sacpase.
Yeah, man, that's what's up, man. Yeah, that's what's up, man. Thank you. ¿Cómo
cusata?
Kuma Kusa. What's up, man?
How you doing?
Good, man.
I'm good.
You from here?
Yeah, I'm living here.
Okay, what's the best thing about living in Palenque?
The culture.
That's what I'm here for. I want to learn the culture.
The cultural identity, you know.
The identity, huh?
You know, especially the people. You know, when you come here, you're like Afro descendant. Because you are not Afro American, you are Afro descendant.
You heard that, guys? Okay.
You come from Africa, and when you come here, you feel like it. That's energy. That's vibes. You know, that's vibe. That's that we come from the same part. We come from the same fight. We are the same people. We are the same. You understand? And it's good. And you come and to now part of our real culture. Where are we coming from? Where you are? What? Who you
and
are?
learn more about here.
All different things.
Because you know, people always ask me, are there black people in Colombia? And I'm like, okay, yes.
Fuera de África.
Sí.
Colombia es la tercera nación con más
africanos. Saying outside of Africa, Colombia has the most, the third country that has the most African population in the world.
That is what we have to show to the, those people that don't know, you know, all about that. We have to show. We have to show. We go, you know, I think that is like a part of the politics, you know, part of the government, you know. You know that have to show, you know, in Palenque, because even when you look at Colombian representation,
sometimes you don't see you guys on television and the media, and that's that could be a problem.
A lot of people think that Colombia is only drop. Colombia is only white people. Colombia is more than here. Diversidad, diversidad.
Diverse.
Diverse in Colombia. The more important thing for me in Palenque to show the world is the black people can live in unity.
Man, thank you, thank you. He's gonna bring me to the party tonight, okay? Maybe I see you, okay?
You are in town.
Today? We're the party tonight?
Yeah, today, yo.
I want to see the party.
Training for many guys here to join, you know.
¿Cómo la gente bailar aquí? Salsa, que pelea.
Champeta. Champeta, Africa, champeta music, you know.
Okay.
It's Africa, out of Africa.
Uh-huh. Okay, here we go. We following him. Let's go. All right. Got that music playing. Got the boys playing the game. What's up, brother? All right.
What's up, brother? Welcome,
Palenque. Okay. Okay, welcome. I'm happy. I'm so muy contento para conozca la cultura, la gente. Mira mi gente que tiene mis colores. Muy alegre.
Yo. Okay.
I'm very happy to be here. Yeah.
Puedes caminar, puedes conocer.
Okay, gracias. Okay, thank you. All right. So I guess that's where the hood boys hanging out. The boys hanging out.
Okay. ¿Y en Haití qué cosa es importante?
En Haití, bueno, Haití ayuda a Colombia.
Claro. Y Colombia, el presidente Simón Bolívar
fui a Haití,
pero lo traicionó porque una de las decisiones era de que una vez conseguida la libertad en Colombia, él tenía que concederle a todos los negros la libertad.
Pero
no,
no lo hizo.
Solo en 1850-51 es que se logra la libertad, la abolición total de la esclavización. Entonces Simón Bolívar quedó y tuvo una deuda con
Haití,
con el general Petión,
que
le suministró hombres y armas para la independencia. Entonces estamos pendientes.
This guy knows his. He really knows his history, basically, guys. So, I'm gonna just paraphrase what he said, but he was talking about how the person that really liberated Colombia, which was Gran Colombia at the time, which was Colombia, Venezuela, and Ecuador, was a guy named Simón Bolívar. He is from Venezuela, that part of the world at the time, and he basically needed some help. He lost a battle in Cartagena. He went to Jamaica, and they tried to assassinate him. One of the people he was with, and then he asked for help from the Americans, or not the Americans, the English, but they said no. So he went to Haiti. At the time, Haiti had just, well, they were already independent, and the president of Haiti said, all right, I'll give you some help. I'm gonna give you some money. I'm gonna give you some gunpowder. I'm gonna give you some men, but you need to free all of us, right? The people, the black people, the slaves. And Simón agreed, but he didn't keep his end of the bargain. I think so. he had slaves. Simón had slaves. I think he let go of his slaves. So they saying Simón tiene slaves y dejó libre, pero no el país.
No el país.
So he had slaves.
No hizo el decreto que reglamentara la abolición total. Como presidente, entonces fue una deuda que tuvo ahí.
There's a debt that hasn't been paid.
Tu cosa favorita que estás aquí en Palenque.
Mi cosa favorita aquí. Disfrutar el paisaje.
He likes to go around the passageway over here, probably messing with mujeres.
aquí en Palenque tenemos muchas cosas que contarle.
Okay.
Por ahí porque todos son hermanos de nosotros.
He said come because we're all brothers from each other.
Aquí en Palenque lo queremos todos los negros. Son hermanos para nosotros, los queremos.
¿Qué música está o what are you listening to?
Trap,
champeta.
Champeta.
En trompa ya, tú sabes que es en trompa.
¿Qué es trompa?
Es de allá, la mujer.
Suave. Aquí en mi país, en Haití, se llama compa, me compa, el guye. Guye. Se llama, pero me compa.
Aquí es la caída y el trompa.
So guys, they decided not to have police here because it was a lot of construction, corruption happening here. So they decided, entonces no más policía.
No, aquí no, nunca ha habido policía aquí.
Never was police here.
Aquí tenemos algo que se llama guardias y marrones, o sea,
guardias y morones.
Guardias y marrones, o sea, son mayores de la comunidad.
I guess it's probably an unspoken thing people know, like if you're of older age, you're supposed to guide the youth on what to do. Okay, guys, this is not like a police station here, but apparently it's like a justice building.
Yeah.
So he's famous because he walks around without a shirt.
Lo que pasa es que como el segundo, el de los guías de Palenque, después de los pasados, era yo.
He's the second guide of this town. So he pretty much helped create this tourism buzz. And okay, that's what's up, man. That's the same guy. He was basically saying that the reason why he doesn't wear a shirt is because the sun feeds him. He really loves the exposure of the sun ever since he was a child. He doesn't feel right unless he feels the beams from the sun. That's awesome. So guys, this is a particular type of rum they make here.
Contra. Es un licor artesanal hecho aquí en la comunidad con plantas medicinales que sirve para la limpieza del cuerpo y para estar ready.
Para ready.
Yeah.
Para ready. Fuerte.
Fuerte.
Fuerte. Fuerte. Yeah, it's a bunch of herbs in here. It's smelling like vodka. It's like a tequila. No, es con tequila.
Poquito.
It's like a moonshine, guys, basically. So, guys, this is basically a place where you can get your local traditional medicine right here. The medicine man. It's interesting to see, so let's check out what we got going on here.
¿Ensalada?
¿Hay un medicine para ser flaco? Is there, like, a medicine to get people skinny?
No la llevamos toda.
We will all take that. So, guys, let's check out what's in the back right here. I hear some pigs. What's up, homie? What's going on? You gonna come show us a love? He's challenging my snort. It's working, guys. He sounds like a motorbike. Who would have thought I know how to speak pig? I know how to speak pig. What's up, homie? You all right? You all right? Awesome. I know how to speak pig. Awesome. Well, they say you are what you eat. That's awesome.
Diabetismo. Y también este bejuco, la raíz de él, la utilizamos para personas que tienen presión.
So basically, guys, he's preserving the medical culture of this town. And so he talks about using different various herbs to create medicine for people. And it's interesting, though. I'm assuming if you go to Africa, certain villages, you're gonna find medicine doctors everywhere. And so I'm gonna ask him, where does he think his connection in Africa comes from? If he can say anything.
All right. También
tenemos. Dicen que nosotros los palenqueros venimos todo lo que tiene que ver de la costa occidental del África. Somos descendientes de allá.
De la costa.
Costa.
Lo gente de Palenque. Y bueno, ese aquí es el cultura de África o de aquí de Palenque, la gente. Aquí,
tenemos casi las mismas costumbres que nos dejaron nuestros antepasados. Uh-huh. Somos descendientes africanos y por eso nosotros en nuestra comunidad adoramos a nuestros dioses. La misma costumbre que tienen los africanos allá, también la tenemos acá en América, pero con una adaptación al continente americano. Oh,
bueno, hay muchas culturas, hay mucha gente que piense de todo, muchas cosas. ¿Qué piense? Hay gente que piense los africanos de Israel, hijos de Israel. ¿Qué piense de eso?
Nosotros, ¿do you believe in that? Nosotros en nuestra comunidad de San Basilio, Palenque, no somos mucho devotos a la religión católica. Uh-huh. Vamos a los sitios de culto católico es cuando se nos muere una persona querida, misa de un difunto amigo, pero muy poco. Las misas dominicales, que son los domingos, en Palenque apuradamente van 5, 6, 8 personas. Pero no van muchas personas. No somos mucho devotos a la religión católica. Uh-huh. Porque nuestros antepasados nos dejaron en nuestros genes cuál era nuestra religión. Adoramos a nuestros dioses. Adoramos a la naturaleza. Pero no somos católicos de vocación.
Oh, no, bueno, hermano, no. Ya contesta bien.
Ok.
Gracias, hermano. Ok, thank you.
Atauto Vega. Mm-hmm. Hasta la próxima. Atauto Vega. Mm-hmm. O hasta luego.
Hasta último.
Vega.
Hasta último Vega. Gracias, gracias, hermano. You know, I noticed that narrative on my my channel. Everybody wants to connect biblical terms to what they see in society. And what he said was made a lot of sense. But I'm not here to preach to you, but I wanted to give you that because I know people are going to ask about that. So there it is for you, okay? He basically was saying that you gotta think about the religion that was people believed beforehand. All right, guys, so we at Joely's cousin house here in Palenque. We're gonna go see what they're cooking right now. Let's do it.
Bueno, Leon, ella es Suni. Suni es mi prima. Suni nos ha invitado acá a su casa. Vamos a almorzar aquí con ella.
Okay. Aquí les presento el arroz de coco frito, el típico de la comunidad de San Basilio de Palenque. Wow. Y aquí están unas mojarras fritas.
She got some fried fish right here. Esa es la comida típica que todo el mundo come.
Aquí en San Basilio de Palenque.
¿Cuál es tu favorita comida?
El arroz de coco, pero en blanco.
¿Blanco?
Blanco.
Sí. ¿Cuál es el diferente?
Porque este frito con este hecho, uno raya el coco, lo cuela, le saca el primer zumo de coco, le echa un poquito de azúcar o panela y lo ponemos a freír. Mi favorita es el arroz blanco de coco con pescado y una ensalada de aguacate, que ahora mismo no hay aguacate.
Hay un mercado aquí.
Hay un mercado, no, super tiendas. Aquí hay varias personas que lo traen de fuera y luego uno lo compra acá. Hay unos que salen también a Cartagena, como Malagana, Mate, que también se encuentran más económicos.
Basically, they outsource their food here.
Bueno, aquí tenemos gallina, que uno no es necesario salir afuera a buscarla, el cerdo, el carnero.
Al hermano del finca, algo así.
De finca, sí, estos son de finca.
These are
como
like farm
el conejo.
Food.
El conejo, la guatinaja, el amarillo, uno lo consigue aquí mismo entre los montes. Ese sí hay que cazarlo.
Para. Oh, yeah, I gotta take this mask off. Everybody's not wearing one. Pero es un cosa típico. Habla nosotros cosas de Palenque, el comida de Palenque.
O sea, what is la like, comida give us something típica about. Típica de aquí es el bleo.
Bleo.
El bleo.
¿Qué es el bleo?
El bleo es una mata terrestre que nace en cualquier parte del monte, luego es una mata verde. Uno la cortan y por lo menos la mamá mía y la abuela mía es que hacen el bleo, pero en este momento no es tiempo de bleo.
Okay, so basically the typical food is called bleo. I'm sure it has an English word. Her mom and her aunt makes it really well, but it's not the time. ¿Cuándo es el tiempo por bleo?
El bleo es de agosto.
So in August time, you can come here and get some bleo. How do you like living in Palenque?
¿Cómo me gusta?
Sí.
Normal, libre, uno es...
¿Ese tú nació aquí?
Sí, nací aquí.
Okay, bueno. Wow, mira esa comida. Es un cocina.
Esta es una cocina.
All right, guys, so she's starting the fire, tree bark, and adding it. In the middle is some chips. Let me give you guys a close-up look at how it look. Oh, wow, putting some corn on there. As you can see, she's blowing into it. Ah, wow.
Coco.
Okay, guys, so she's also putting the shell of the
esto
cocoa.
Esto lo que hace que la llama aumente más.
Nothing goes to waste here. Even the shells of the cocoa is going to be used for wood fire. So she'll continue to fan the flames to keep the oil burning. And it's an interesting process, but it's totally energy free. It's free. Wow. It smells awesome, guys. That smell is so alluring, man. Straight off the pan, okay? And then she's gonna put it there, I guess, to calm down. Okay.
Para que no lo toque.
Nadie puede tocar, see? That way it don't fall.
Caliente.
It's real hot. And she picked it up like a boss.
Porque me vine para el pueblo y no los estoy atendiendo. Yo los atiendo. No cociné yo, pero aquí los estoy atendiendo.
All right, guys, so here is the food. Looking amazing. Yes. So now I'm gonna try some of this rice right here. This is a cocoa rice, but made in Palenque. It's supposed to be a little bit different from what I've ate before, so let's try it. Off the rip, taste the cocoa extract. It's really good. That sounds crunchy too, man. That's good. Yeah. She's already into the fish. Look at her.
Vamos a probar qué tal está. Delicioso.
Ya no voy a hablar más porque lo voy a disfrutar.
¿Es un qué?
Agua de panela.
Okay, guys, so sugar cane juice right here. Try some of this, guys.
Esto era lo que yo necesitaba.
Like a Ness iced tea. It's very refreshing. Oh, she said she needed this.
Esto era lo que necesitaba.
Nice flavored. Thank you, Suni, for showing us how to cook food. We really appreciate it. If you guys come to Palenque, look for Suni. Tú puedes hacer algo por gente si quiere. ¿Viene aquí?
Claro, sí, siempre.
¿Cómo hacerlo? ¿Nosotros llamar a ti o...?
Me contactan en mi número 322-3853-457.
Okay. That's Colombian number, guys. I'm gonna put her information in the description if you want to eat some of her food. Okay, gracias, okay. More. Okay.
Siempre a la orden.
Okay,
bye. Y siempre bienvenido. Aquí está Suni por siempre para que me tengan en cuenta. Bye.
Bye, okay. So one thing that's noticeable is there's no end of the animals here. And there goes the goat right here. Tony Baker Cram. What's up? Cram. Oh, ain't no crap. What's up, player? What's up? Okay, I got you. Man, I'm full from that food. Okay, we're entering another crosswords here. There's like a little bar here.
Vamos a ver el antiguo palenque.
Oh, it's older palenque that way? What's up, brothers? ¿Cómo está? ¿Todo bien? Yo soy de Estados Unidos. Oh, bueno. ¿Qué pasando? ¿Estás bebiendo?
Lo que tenía miedo.
Boxing. ¡Peleando! Boxing. King box. Halo box. Oh, okay. It's going down now. Let's get it. Yo.
Okay. Bueno. ¿Qué es este?
Bien.
Fuerte.
Es un tequila, ¿verdad?
Fuerte. ¿Cómo se llama?
Ese es el propio churrito.
Churrito.
Tequila palenquero. Pero bueno para destruir.
Said it's really good for destroying.
No, pero para que lo vi.
Man, guys, as you move further back in town, things just get a little bit more natural around here. As you can see those hills, this place is awesome, man.
¿Qué está haciendo allá al frente? Hola, ¿cómo estás? What's up?
It's like beautiful ground right there. It looks like it's being groomed there. I don't know how it looks like that. Man, I didn't bring my drone to get close up to that.
So this is the entry into Old Palenque. It seems like you just walk in, okay? It's a different type of energy here. It's beautiful though. Oh my gosh. This is beautiful. Man, this is awesome, man. I feel like this is like heaven or something. You're walking down. There's so much history there.
Esa es una recreación que hicieron.
Ah, it's a recreation of how it used to look. So let's do it.
Here is the old palenque. Let's go through.
This is a replica. So first thing you see is cornfields. These are real cornfields. And then let's go here. What's this? I guess this is where they bring people if you're on a tour to eat food. And we walk through these areas right here. And you see some of these mud huts. Let's get in one of these. Nice. Okay. Made out of wood. Dry dirt. Mud. It's all mud. Nice and cool in here. Okay. Could you imagine? I know this is a replica. Could you imagine, though, people, slaves, walking through this village? Proud, free, the joy. If you pay attention to what they were saying today, this city, this town is a friendly town, brotherly love, united by an event that took place hundreds of years ago. You wanna see something, guys? Let's do it. Let's run through it. Let's feel it. Ah, I wanna feel it. I wanna feel it.
Ah. Freedom. Freedom, breaking away from slavery. What's that? I see people. I see people. I see people by the... They look like me, though. Where's their master? Do they have a master? Let me get closer. I see more people that look like me. Welcome home, my brother. You are now free, far away from slavery. You came a long way. You travel thousands of miles. Understand what it means to be free. This is why you go to places like this, guys. Understand the history, put yourself in a predicament, make you appreciate things. Awesome.
Uno, dos, tres, come on. Africa! Africa!
Thank you.